In this video, I'm going to show you how to build this minimal habit tracker where you have different routines, and then inside of each routine you have your different daily habits with a checkbox for each day that updates the weekly progress as you complete them. And then once you've successfully completed the habit during the week, you can just update this number, which will show your total yearly progress. And then at the end of the week, when you have a bunch of checkboxes, all you want to do is just click on this reset habits button, click on continue, and it will automatically uncheck all of these checkboxes. Now, in order to add or remove habits, simply right click on one of them and click on delete, or click on this new button to add a new habit, add 0 for the completed weeks, and then just give your habit an icon. So let's start building this habit tracker. The first thing we're going to do is create a routines database. So go ahead and create a new gallery view database, delete one of these pages, and then we're going to rename this first one to morning and then the second one to evening. We can also add an icon to both of these and also delete these two properties. The only property we're going to add is going to be a text property, which is going to be for the time. And here you can specify the duration of your morning routine. We can also do the exact same thing for our evening routine. All right, so once that's in place, you can go back to your database view, click on the database menu, go to properties and show the time property. And then you can also go inside of layout and then change the card preview to none, change the card size to small. And then you can also rename this view. You can just delete this and add a space to remove the name. And then you can also change the icon. So once your routine database is created, you can create a callout box. And then with caps lock and a space in between each letter, you can add in the word routine and then make it bold, underline it and change the text color. And then drag your routine database inside. So now that the routine database is done, we can go ahead and create a new table view database. And this one will be for our habits. Now let's go ahead and hide the database title, delete the stack property, and then remove this database view name by just adding in the space and then also give it an icon. All right, so let's just add in one morning and evening routine. So for the morning routine, we can add in a cold shower habit. And for the evening, we can add in journal. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to add in 7 checkboxes for the 7 days of the week. So the first one is going to be called Monday. Then we can just click on duplicate and then we can just rename this to Tuesday and then just repeat this process for all 7 days of the week. All right, so once you've added in a checkbox for every day of the week, you want to add a number property, which will be called completed weeks. And then for this number property, you want to select the progress ring and then divide this by 52 because there's 52 weeks in a year. And then whenever you successfully complete the habit for the week, you just update this and then throughout the year, you can see your weekly streak for that habit. Now the next property is going to be a formula, which is going to be for the weekly progress. For this formula, all you want to do is just select your Monday checkbox, add a 2 number function with a plus, press shift enter and tab, and then add in the next day of the week. And then you just repeat this process for all 7 days of the week. So basically what we're doing is we're turning a checkbox value, which is true or false, into a number value, which is 1 or 0. And then we're counting all of them together. And then what we're doing is we're dividing everything with 7 because there's 7 checkboxes. And then this will give us a percentage value. And then what we're also going to do is just add in a round function in the beginning. And then at the end, multiply everything with 100 and divide everything with 100 in order to get rid of the decimals. And then when you click on done, you want to just change the number format to percentage and then select the progress ring and then also hide the number. And now if we go ahead and check off our checkboxes, you'll see that our weekly progress will now update. Now the final property we're going to add is going to be a relation property to this routine database. And then just make sure to show it on the routine database as well. So inside of this routine relation is where you're going to link your habits to a specific routine. So our cold shower habit is going to be a part of our morning routine and our journal habit is going to be part of our evening routine. So once all of your habit database properties are set up, you want to click inside of the database menu, go to layout and then change it to a list view database. And then for this list view database, you just want to click inside of your database menu, go to properties and just show all of the properties except the routine relation and then just make sure they're in the correct order. So here we have our completed weeks at the top and then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. And then our weekly progress at the bottom. Now for this database, we're also going to go inside of our database menu and inside of the group tab, we're going to group this database according to the routine relation. And then we're just going to hide the empty groups, change the sort to manual and then move morning to the top. And now all you want to do is just add in all of of your morning and evening habits, and then also change the icon for each of them. Now, when you add new habits to your routine, just make sure to add a zero to your completed week's property, otherwise the progress bar won't show up. And it's also important to note that you can't relate the same habit with multiple routines, like meditate, for example. You have to create separate ones. Otherwise, if you check off the checkboxes for the evening, it will also check it off for the morning as well. And then once you've added in all of your habits, just click on this group function and then select average and then click on the weekly progress. And now next to morning, it will show the total weekly progress for all of your habits. And then once this is done, just create another callout box and add in the word habits, and then just highlight all of this and make it bold, underline it, change the text color, add an icon, and then drag your database inside. And then once your habit tracker is done, all you want to do is just create a button which will edit pages in and then this habit tracker database. And then all you want to do is just select the Monday checkbox and then select unchecked. And then just click on edit another property, select Tuesday, and then just repeat this process for all 7 days of the week. And then once this is done, you just want to click on add another step, click on show confirmation, and then just move this to the top. And then all you want to do is just give this button a name as well as add an icon. And then whenever you click this button, it will automatically uncheck all of the checkboxes. And there you go. If you're looking for a more advanced habit tracker that allows you to have specific habits for specific days, tracks your progress throughout the day, week, month, quarter, and year, as well as have an accountability partner showing your daily progress, then be sure to check out the video that's on the screen now. Make sure to give this video a like. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.